UW360 is proudly supported by Pacific Office Automation, copy, print, workflow, and IT, problem solved.
Zoe has her father's eyes and a long family history of colorblindness.
On my dad's side, his father was colorblind. My mom's side, her father was colorblind. And my dad's colorblind, and my uncle's colorblind. So in the end, my brother and I had high probability of being colorblind.
Zoe is one of over 250 million people worldwide who suffer from color vision deficiencies.
So if you look at the building, the darker tiles, for me, they look dark green. The lighter ones look very brown.
Without red and green, the world is just a lot less vibrant and makes certain patterns invisible.
My brother came home when he was in high school with a shirt that was burgundy and tan. It didn't look like the kind of shirt he would typically wear. So I said, you know, do you know about the elephants on your shirt? He said, what elephants?
Growing up with a colorblind sibling sparked Maureen's passion for understanding this genetic disorder. Today, she is one of UW's leading vision researchers alongside her husband, Jay Neitz.
Yeah, this idea of using these monkeys that are colorblind just like people. And we developed a viral vector that carried a human photopigment gene that was missing in these monkeys. And we injected it into the eye.
Everybody thought it would not work. So we actually didn't think it would work either. So we were very stunned when it actually did work.
Find the chip here that looks most like that one and put it next to it.
We're always trying to invent new technology that allows us to do experiments and measure the outcome in a way that there's nothing out there that we can use.
Jay and Maureen believe they have the magic bullet, a non-surgical intravitreal injection.
It's just a shot in the eye, which is something people have now on a monthly basis to treat macular degeneration. And some people have up to 80 of these injections in their eye in their lifetime. So it's very well tolerated. It's something that's accepted.
The next step for Jay and Maureen is to get FDA approval to move forward with clinical trials. They hope to have the shot available to the public in 2016.
I get probably a few hundred emails every week of people that tell me, you know, why they wish they had their color vision cured. And most of it, it's because they can't get the job that was always of their dream.
From firefighters to nurses to airline pilots, color blindness often prohibits people from many career opportunities. But Jay and Maureen's research doesn't stop with this cure.
And so we hope that not only are we going to help, you know, millions of people, you know, that have color blindness, but then moving forward with these same technologies will actually be able to cure many of the unsolved problems where people lose their vision. It's so exciting because we get to discover new things that change the world. That's, you know, a great feeling.